Okay, hello people, got up late again. Feel bad because I was supposed to meet a friend for lunch, like a really good friend, and I totally slept through it because last night I was editing a video, then I started listening to a podcast. It was amazing. I listened to another episode. I was on a roll. I'm gonna make a video soon about sleep hygiene and stuff, and like how I've been trying so hard to get up in the morning and failing miserably because I'm a night person. Yep. Having a chat, you can't see it, but it's on the screen, having a chat with my friend Eric back in my hometown of Lévy. He's rooting for the hurricane, and I'm like, what? You don't like Ovi? Ovechkin? He's such a... C'est tellement un joueur combatif, Alexandre Ovechkin. Il a peut-être mauvais caractère, puis il manque une dent en avant, mais on s'en colle dessus. T'as un esti de bon joueur de hockey. Il joue la partie à lui tout seul, tu sais. I have a lot of respect for Alexander Ovechkin. And he goes back to his country, Russia, to play there. So it's always cool. But my friend's like, you know, it's like, oh, he's a Sid the Kid person. All right, I'm gonna have to say goodbye for now. I can't see my screen. Like, well, how does this work? Okay. Because I was texting my friend while... Yeah, and then I was supposed to go to lunch with my friend at 11, and I put an alarm. Never heard it. So I feel really bad right now. I know my friend's going to forgive me, but still, it's kind of... Anyway. Cool. Look at that. He sent me a little monkey. How cool is that? I gotta send a sticker back. Like, right now, I am texting on my phone. I have no idea what the image looks like. Probably, like, my nose or something. Stickers. Friend. I wanna send something back. Like, I like taking the time to chat with some of my friends when they're online and they're like, hey, how's it going? You know, I have a friend... This friend, Eric, from my hometown, we talk about hockey, and there you go. And I have one in France, a really dear friend of mine from France, Jill, also. She's like, hey, how you doing? And when she talks to me, usually it's the morning for her, and it's like maybe the late night for me. She's in France. All right, so I like having the time to just, you know, say hello and shit. All right, I don't know how to, okay. Anyways, let's go. Don't tell anyone, but I have not been locking the door at all since I've been here, because what's the point? It's just a waste of time. Yeah, so when I'm texting my friends, usually I have to change the language all the time, like every sentence between French and English, because it does not give you the same word suggestions or spellings. And sometimes it makes it faster for me, because if you've ever received a text or an email or a message from me, you know that I am not the short and sweet kind of person. I write complete sentences with adverbs and punctuation and commas and parentheses. So yeah, it is spell checked by me, not a machine, and grammatically correct. What you want? I'm a Capricorn. So yeah, I always have to change the little thing, like English, French. And sometimes I'm writing in French and then if, like, the English words are coming, I'm like, fuck. Yes. Welcome to the life of a fully bilingual person. Now we're going to Kits. I'm going to get a stapler. I have a pool table here. You think I could actually go in there and play pool? Let's check it out. Does it work? No, it didn't work. Okay. I can't go there? How come? I mean, I have the key. The light became green. No, it's not working. Can't play pool, you know? Okay, whatever. Like a couch. yeah, this is a pretty nice building. I'll talk to you about that soon because I have to make other plans for the continuation of my trip, because I'm not gonna stay here forever, although I wouldn't mind. Do you think we can go in there? It's locked. Like, everything here is locked. Like, as you know, like the key you have only gives you access to your own floor and the floor, like the ground floor, the parking where there is the recycling, and the third floor where there's a pool, a sauna, a gym, etc. But what if you made a friend in your own building? You can't even visit the people in your own building. I don't like these kind of things. You know, I don't like anything that's exclusive, that's keeping people out. I understand that they don't want homeless people coming in, but do you really think a homeless guy would trek all the way up here, try to get in that building? I don't think so. You know, they could put a key to the gym room, the pool room, you know. But, like, do you really, like, people lock their doors. Do you really think that people are going to hang out in the hallways, sleeping on the floor? I don't think so. Anyways, un autre commentaire éditorial ici. Every time I see a white van now, that kind of looks like this, I'm like, is this chrome? But no, that's not chrome. His van is cleaner than that. I hope we're going to see him someday. He's around this neighborhood sometimes, so you never know. Might see him at some point. The guy was telling you about makes videos while living in his van. Because weirdos unite. Look at that greenery. It's 4 Celsius back home. I'd say it's about 13 today. You can feel there's a little chill in the air, and later on I'm gonna need a sweater, but right now it's beautiful. Yield Town. Des fois, j'ai envie d'appeler ça Yuppie Town, mais bon. No, Yield Town is nice. full of like hidden, like I call them Pokeglyph. It's like hieroglyphs, but it's a Pokemon thing. Look, there's a rabbit right there. Look at this. What is that? It looks like a cross between a Pac-Man and a pig. Look, you have a cat in the window, and then what? And this person here. There's a lot of details. You know, it's kind of like a Where's Waldo thing. Where's Pancho? Hey, you know what we should do? We should take a picture of Pancho and then print it and just put it in the picture, because the colors really fit. Oh yeah, that is a great idea. Awesome. Rhyme City Blues Cafe. Oh. Here's our bus. Regarde, ma place est réservée. À droite ou à gauche? Des fois, je m'assieds au milieu. And this is what we are currently reading. Radical Vulnerability by Merfan. And the zine comes all the way from Germany, people. Yes. Alors, on va aller prendre l'autobus 22 l'autre bord de la rue. Shoe sale. Hundreds of pairs. I'm like, what the fuck, man? What are you doing to me? Don't show me stuff like that. Bon, on vient de manquer notre autobus. C'est pas grave, on prendra l'autre d'après. On me tente pas de courir après. We're heading to Kitsilano to pick up a stapler. That was nice. I will write to them. I don't want to say she because I don't know. It doesn't. And yeah, the glitter from the zine is transferring to my fingers, which is super cool. À Montréal, qui a une brasserie Molson, et une à Kitsilano aussi, à Vancouver. Donc, Kitsilano, ici, il y a une plage, t'en vois pas par là. Et la rue principale, c'est la 4e avenue. Et on doit monter une côte pour se rendre. Fait que là, t'as comme Cornwall Street, puis là, t'as 1e, 2e, 3e, 4e. Mon ami habite entre la 2e et la 3e, ce sera pas si pire. Regarde, encore des kakusakura, mes préférés. Gros pompons roses. Ça donne envie de marcher dans cette rue-là, mais... Ce n'est pas sur notre chemin, mais on peut toujours faire un petit détour. Voilà pourquoi j'aime avoir tout mon temps pour me rendre quelque part, partir d'avance, avoir des tonnes de temps pour pouvoir faire des détours, des arrêts sur le chemin, parce que moi, je suis toujours en train de regarder autour de moi. Je vois des centaines d'affaires sur un chemin. Je vois des fleurs, je vois des arbres, je vois des affaires écrites sur ces poteaux. Et j'aime ça pour pouvoir prendre le temps de m'arrêter. L'anneau, c'est l'autre côté du Burrard, le bridge, du Burrard Inlet. C'est un quartier qui est, je dirais... qu'il y a des côtés balnéaires. C'est un quartier un peu plus relax, un peu plus tranquille. C'est moins ville, OK? C'est moins urbain. Les gens ici sont plus plein air, plage. Il y a des endroits que ça va être plus plein air, montagne. Ici, c'est vraiment plein air, plage. Il y a plus de plantes et d'arbres. Ouais, il y a plus de plantes. Il y a peut-être pas plus de plantes dans... Peut-être pas plus d'arbres dans les rues, mais les jardins, des immeubles, c'est... Je sais pas, c'est un peu une atmosphère un peu différente. C'est un peu funky. Je dirais que c'est... Si j'avais à comparer ça à un quartier de Québec, je reste au Nam, mais à place de la montagne, la plage. Alright, people, so thank you so much to my friend Terry, who's also a longtime zinester, and she does the zine Only Hooligans Write on Desks and Other Zines. So I'm borrowing her long reach stapler, because if you make a zine that's bigger than a quarter size, you need this kind of stapler, because a regular stapler cannot reach the middle of your zine, like for the Happy Loner and 11 and 12, and pretty much all my regular zines, I need this kind of stapler. And you can staple a quarter size zine with a regular stapler, but it's still a pain in the ass, so this is perfect. I have a saddle stitch back home, but yeah, this will do. It's perfect. Oui, alors j'ai été chercher une brocheuse pour mes zines. Ça prend une grosse brocheuse comme ça, une petite brocheuse ordinaire, ça fait pas. C'est l'heure d'un cornet! Yes, c'est l'heure d'un cornet de crème glacée. Ooh. Oh my god, c'est bien stocké ça! Hey, this is a well-stocked little library. Sometimes you can find, like, most of the books that are in here are stuff that people donated, discarded, so there's a lot of crap. But sometimes you can find a gem, and I'm pretty good at finding them. I found a book last year. It was so good. It was called... What was it called? Ah, I forgot, but it was about, like, a Chinese person who pretended to be a food critic so he could go and taste food everywhere for free, and it was so funny. What's the name of it? The Banquet, I think. It's in English. It was so freaking good. Oh, look at this. I love you, but I hate your politics. How to protect your intimate relationships in a poisonous partisan world. Okay. Why don't you just say what you think, and if people don't like you, then you say, fuck off. That's my strategy. How's that been working for you? Not bad. All the friends I still have are real friends. I don't know. the kindness method. Do you really need a book to tell you how to be kind to people? It's pretty simple. I mean, I like the idea, but I'm not gonna read a book on it. The emotion code. The man that got away. Really? Oh, look, it looks good. Is this like a detective-like story? Oh my god, this is like a true crime mystery something. Like, this looks cool. Yeah, let's try this one. 1957, in the beach town of Brighton, music is playing and guests are sunning themselves when a young man is found dead, dripping blood, in a deck chair. Okay, it's like a murder mystery thing. We could check it out. What else? Just pick one. You cannot. I'm trying to limit my intake of books because I already have a lot. Although this autopsy of a boring wife. Well, maybe her husband was fucking boring. Only boring people get bored. I'm never bored, ever. I will never be bored one second. How can you be bored? This is life. Like, there's so much. If you're bored, you have a problem. I don't know. I like to look, you know. I'm looking for the highway in all caps. So it's gonna be either this one or this one. I mean, it looks fun, but I mean, I've had murder mysteries before. I kind of know what it is. What is this about? A French-Canadian name. Marie-Renée Lavoie, donc est-ce une traduction? She's from Quebec. La Presse, yeah. She's probably a Quebec writer, too. I think I'm gonna try this one. Like a Quebecois Bridget Jones's diary. Marie-Renée Lavoie's autopsy of a boring wife tells the hysterically funny and ultimately moving tale of a 48-year-old Diane, a woman whose husband has left her and is having an affair because he says she bores him. Well, no, he's the one who's boring. Diane takes the change to heart and carries. Diane takes the charge to heart and carries along a ribald
merciless and highly entertaining astute commentary on the high stakes of love, the friendship of women, and the curious institution of marriage in the 21st century. We're taking a lot of time here. What about this one? Game changer. It's big. What is that? The world ended? Humanity did not? Is that like a futuristic? Yeah, look at that. What is that? I don't know. Let's check this out. This looks pretty cool too. This looks different. I don't know which book to pick. I don't know. It looks better. Because these, you can kind of predict what it's going to be. You know, and I've read so many books in my life. You know, I know how a murder mystery goes. I know how a tale of, like, the husband leaves, blah, 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 goes. I don't want to diminish any of your writing efforts, but genuine fakes. How phony things teach us about real stuff. Really? What the fuck is that? Is the distinction between real and fake as clear-cut as we might think? From fake fur to man-made diamonds to art forgeries and staged nature documentaries, our everyday lives are full of things that are considered fake. I'm trying to articulate more on my videos because sometimes when I listen to it while I'm editing, I'm like, man, can barely make out what I'm saying. But the concept of a fake is not as clear-cut as we might believe. Often, the social history, scientific background, and cultural context of genuinely fakes objects... let's do that again. A cultural context of genuinely fake... Where is there an S here? Genuinely fake objects contain very real knowledge about the world in curious and unexpected ways. This seems interesting. And it's not a novel, it's like a real... It's kind of like an... Almost like a study of some sort. Yeah, I think I'll take this one. This one looked cool too. If you want it, come and take it. It's at Pacific and Burrard in the library. It's big too. I mean, I could get that at the borrow it at the library, read it, and return it, so I wouldn't have to carry it. All right, what's that? The scar. Okay, I saw another one. Is there still Sex in the City? Oh,
basically.
Advanced reading coffee. What the fuck? I don't know. This looks also interesting. I like cities. I followed the Sex and the City series. It was avant-garde at the time in the 90s, in the late 90s. But now when you watch back episodes of Sex and the City, you're like, wow, this is so actually not feminist. And it's like kind of sexist. And it's kind of like promotes stereotypes. And it's kinda, yeah, like you'll watch episodes. I could do a whole commentary like on every fucking episode, and I'm like, whoa, nowadays, like, we have evolved, and those episodes would not bode well today. Like, I think they still run like late at night, but I'm like, some of these episodes are like, the kind of like, sometimes there's like homophobic or racist or sexist shit in there that even like the girls are carrying out, and especially Carrie. I'm like, oh my god, she's so stupid. But then again, sometimes I was like that in my 20s. But she's in her 30s. She's like 35. She has no excuse. Anyway, she's a fictional character. Which one? Well, this is interesting. Okay, let's take this. Man. Maybe if I have space in my suitcase. Yeah, right. I'm gonna come back and take a few. Yeah. Yeah. Only one. Let's go. A children's section underneath. It's pretty cool. And I always leave zines in these. So if you're looking for my zines, check the library boxes. I always leave some in there. Look, here's an ad for a glass blowing course. Un cours de verre soufflé. Ça serait-tu assez hot de faire ça? Je sais pas combien ça coûte, là. Mais ce serait hot de faire ça. Je sais pas comment j'emmènerais mon affaire en verre soufflé, mais on va le prendre. On va m'informer, savoir comment que ça coûte, là. Ça coûte pas trop cher, mais... Mettons que ce serait 40$ et moins, là, je le ferais. Wouh! Un ami! C'est un raton. Il est bien installé dans ces bosquets-là. Est-ce que c'est pas la joie, ça? Oui, en passant, c'est super intéressant le livre que j'ai pris dans la petite bibliothèque. Ça parle du concept de réalité, d'authenticité. Est-ce que ça amène vraiment à la réflexion? Est-ce que je suis juste à quelques pages du début là, puis j'étais déjà comme super passionnée. Tu sais, est-ce que le fait que quelque chose soit vrai, est-ce que ça le rend authentique? Et est-ce que le fait que quelque chose soit réel, est-ce que ça le rend meilleur qu'une chose fausse entre guillemets? Puis moi, je commence à m'interroger. Tu sais, je me dis, qu'est-ce que c'est la réalité? C'est moi, je crée ma propre réalité. Donc, ça m'intéresse ces sujets-là de réflexion. Tu sais, je me dis, qui sont les personnes célèbres à travers le monde? Tu sais, tu dis, c'est qui les personnes les plus célèbres en ce moment? Qui me vient à l'esprit? Mickey Mouse, Sherlock Holmes, ce sont des personnages de fiction. Ils ne sont pas réels et pourtant, tout le monde les connaît, tout le monde croit en eux, tout le monde les trouve hot. Ils n'existent même pas pour vrai. Donc, quelle est la valeur de la réalité et de l'authenticité des choses? Là, ça mène à loin, là. Il y a tellement de sujets. En tout cas, ça serait compliqué à t'expliquer, là. Je n'en parlerai une autre fois parce que j'ai pas trop le temps. Mais oui, je veux dire que c'est passionnant. Je suis contente d'avoir fait ce choix.